Yeah. Inakuaje watu wa online media? Manzee, leo tumekuja kukutanisha jamaa fulani hapa amazing. Anaitwa Daddy Owen.
Yep. Yeah.
Inakuaje bro?
Niko poa sana. I'm excited. Event imeenda poa.
Kabisa. You know, it's
watu wengi washaifanya events watakwambia si rahisi ku plan event alafu iende ishe poa. How you expected?
Hey, bro, so kwanza nikukatishe. Umepiga event tatu. Back to back. Mpaka leo nilikuwa mimi mwenyewe, wacha tu nisiseme ni mafans. Mimi mwenyewe nilikuwa nauliza ama sponsors kwanza. Eti upate M-Pesa Foundation, upate sijui nani wote kuwaleta kwa event yako. How does that work?
For me, I think one, I thank God for the connection that I have because kitu imenisaidia sana kwa hii industry mimi ni more of the reputation that nakuanga nao na hizi makampuni because most of the companies wanakuambia hawapendi scandals, hawapendi mtu ana drama mingi, you understand?
Yeah, yeah.
Because of course we know scandal is like part and parcel of
unaelewa.
But sometimes zinakuangana of course the positive side and the negative side. Because positive side, of course utakuwa na more followers, of course utakuwa midomo za watu kila saa everyone is talking about you, of course so many people will know you, of course you'll become more famous because of the scandals. But on the negative pia kuna zile kampuni, kuna companies jali about the scandals, but there are companies which are very sensitive about who they connect with ama deal with. So for me nasema ni connection because for example, I've worked with the Safaricom for so many years. Tangu around 2009 ndo nianza za kwanza zile tangu za groove na nini, after 2010 tukafanya tour hivyo. Tangu around 2010 ndo tumewaka na Safaricom vizuri sana.
Okay. Yeah. So maybe unajua wase tumesema tuko event nini, wase wajui labda event ni gani, unaweza tuambie event ni gani?
Okay. The event is called Malaika Tribute Awards. Malaika Tribute Awards is an event nilianza 2012 na nilianza due to a song called Mbona ni ngoma tulifanya na Deno. And after we did the song, tulifanya campaign into a Mbona campaign. And after we did the Mbona campaign, ilikuwa ni better tufanya kitu itakuwa na a long-term goal than just a song. So I wanted to do something that is more than a song, more than an artist. So nikaanza kitu Malaika Tribute Awards. Malaika Tribute Awards is an award ceremony whereby we award persons living with disability. I'm a person with disabilities, the ones who've done great things despite their challenges. Wala wasewe awakai tu homo kisema, just because I have a disability, I'm a failure in life, ama I need sympathy, ama I need kusaidia na vitu kama hizo. So these are the people who, I call them the unsung heroes, who have done great things despite their disability. And apart from that, we award even people who are around them, wenye kuna tunye, as much as maybe they're not disabled in a way, they're caregivers who are around them. So like, the theme for this year, ilikuwa to award institutions more than individuals.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, so we went to Eldoret a week ago.
Yeah.
And man, the event was, I think, among the biggest events. Wacha ile tunaseme ti kumekuwa na event msanii international amekuja. That was even ilikuwa imepita over 10,000 people happened to be at the event.
To count the numbers, what we did to print more than 8,000 posters, karibu 8,500 flyers za kupeana for each and every person who was alikuwa anakuja kwa event. Na zilisha by saa sita.
I remember.
By saa sita zilikuwa zimeisha, so inamaanisha tulikuwa na more than 10,000 people. Because saa sita, karibu ilikuwa zina na karibu ilikuwa 4. Four ilikuwa crowd big sana. So we had more than even 10,000 fans.
What does it take, yani, kuleta wasanii wote wenye wanakusupport? Did you pay them? Did you, ama what happened?
For me, what I do is, as much as I work with artists who come to support me, I must make sure I appreciate you as an artist. Because I always say, mi ni msanii kama wewe. So at the end of the day, mara usiende? Okay. At the end of the day, I must make sure that I appreciate you for the work that you do. Because I can't tell you that when msanii alafu nashindwa kumotivate yet mimi pia ni msanii na expected ni kind of event someone to appreciate what I do. So that's what I do. As much as I treat you well as an artist, because all of them in the Malama wachukuliwa flight, wakuja wakaifiti, wachukuliwa wapelekwa, tutupoa yani for them to feel like they, because they are very important people in the society. So for me I always say any artist who I work with, I try as much as possible ni mtreat poa kama msanii vya anafaa kutreatiwa. Yeah.
We have these people who, you know, who have so many ideas and they want to make them a reality by giving our sani platform. And they normally feel like number one kupata sponsor ni kazi, number two kufanya nini nini. Will you mind if you can find a few people ama wenye watakuwa na watch hii video wakiona wa come to you to get the lessons on how you manage to pull all these you know sponsors together and give them a tip on how they should improve our entertainment industry,
some kind of a workshop basically.
Yeah, I think the most important thing, one of the basic information I always tell guys is what is your brand. What is the ideas behind your brand? What is the ideology about behind your brand? Because for me, as much as I am who I am, their brand says you work nazo kwa events zangu. You understand? Na pia kuna brands zingine zizi ni pick kwa events. So let me understand who should I go to and which brand relates to the fans that unaelewa? Because kitu kingine mwambie mse kuna at the end of the day tunaweza kuwa wasanii tofauti but unapata crowd ina appeal to Sauti Sol, crowd yenye ina appeal to na crowd yangu ni very different. Understand? As much as mimi na kana BNC ni mabeshte tuko in the same industry but tuna appeal to very different and diverse crowds. And I always say every artist uko na space yako. Mwambie ase mzibisha ni place moja.
Keki ni kubwa,
manze ni kubwa sana na kila msanii pale huko uko na brand yako na uko na mafans wako na uko na wasanii wana believe eh nikiwa na umse na feeling ipoa. So I always tell guys, number one, you must know that and you need to know at the end of the day if these are my fans, which is the corporate that relates to the fans that I appeal to. You understand? Yeah. And then how are you approaching the corporate? Because hapo ndo pala tuingi ufail. Because you need to approach the corporate with an idea of I'm approaching because I'm going to give you this. Because corporates mingi si charity.
Yeah.
You understand? Even for them, they have to gain something out of your brand. So are you ready to make sure, are you willing to make sure that you must give out something for them to give you something? So those are the few tips that wasanii wanafaa kujua.
And among the things that I was expecting, or rather last time tukiwa Eldoret, I thought nita come across to was the one Deno. I didn't see him at your event. And today, I was expecting to see him.
Yes.
I didn't see him. Did you give him an invitation?
Yes. Today, the best thing, the most interesting part about this event, as you can see the logos here, there are so many different organizations. You know, Otoingo Jejua, there's M-Pesa Foundation, the Safaricom Foundation, and the Safaricom. You understand? Okay. The Safaricom Foundation is not here, their logo.
Yes.
It's not here. But there are three different entities. There's Safaricom, there's M-Pesa Foundation, and Safaricom Foundation. So the guys who are running the event were Safaricom Foundation and M-Pesa Foundation, the ones who are running the event today. So even booking the talents and everything, they're the ones who are booking the talents today. And I remember even the last time we had a conversation and I asked them to call Deno. So today I'll follow it up and understand maybe there's something, but Deno always comes. He was meant to be here. He's always with us when you're doing our own events.
What keeps you going with the...
Remember at my launch, here, the same place.
So in Nissan, actually.
Yeah, he was there at the launch.
What keeps you going with Malaika Awards?
For me, it's just to see the testimonials on the lives that I transform each and every year. Because these guys, after you awarded them like come and lay off your award, the next year I do follow-ups to see
they will come more bigger.
You understand? And sometimes to make what 100,000 today, but unapata, when we come to your projects, we discover that maybe you need more even than 100,000.
Yeah.
I go back to the corporates and tell them the 100 that we give these guys, they need more. So you know, kazi mo fanya. So I do follow up. It's not nimeko appreciate leo and then umeenda. They become like family. That's why you know, nandukama kina Sami Brayo. That's how I knew Sami Brayo. DJ Euphoric, the same thing. They know, same process, you understand? So all these things, zinaanza kama awards, but eventually it's a lifestyle and then you end up becoming a family in future. Yeah.
And of course kuna swali zenye lenye tumekuwa tukiuliza siku ya leo. Najua umeona sana. Usituruke. There is a fight going on online pale kati ya Diana B na Willy Paul. And it's been a yani imekuwa ni kitu kubwa. So we were trying to get the views of the juzi tu ya kwanza ilikuwa tofauti, ya pili imekuja ikakuwa tofauti. What's your take about what's happening now?
I think we've reached a point where we're playing around with big words. The words that for me I feel like we need to know the repercussions and the depth to the words. As in there are things which can finish someone's career. And there are words we can't play around with. And the cases that guys are talking about, these are serious cases. It's not a case to play around with. It reaches a point whereby you don't know what is real, what is not real. And for me, I've not sat down, because I know Willy Paul very well. I know Diana before she became who she is right now. I know Baha from, like all these guys, I've seen them becoming who they are right now. And one thing I know, Willy Paul is very talented. I know Baha is very talented. And even Diana, she's a very hardworking woman. So I know all of them.
Why? Can you be talented?
No, but she's talented and hardworking. I'm an Indian.
There are differences.
Can
you?
No, you know the one thing about life. You can be very talented, but you're not. I know so many hip hop artists. I know so many hip hop artists who are very talented, but they're not hardworking. You understand?
Yeah.
And I know others. Who you can say at your talent to that level, but they're very hardworking.
Right.
But what I know about Diana, she's very hardworking. So I think for me, right now, I don't know, are we talking about the songs? Are we talking about the case? What are we talking about?
The case.
For me, I just
video
feel like,
that she did again, Bahati or Willy Paul replied.
Okay, for me, I just feel like guys are playing around with the. Like I said, with very big words. If I can take you back in history, you remember Bill Cosby, you remember R. Kelly. These are talented people that such cases zinafanya mtu ata kari yake inaisha. So let's just be very careful of what we are talking about, because I know all of these guys, and I know they are very nice people. I feel so sad to see that we are fighting and you're talking about such things towards each other. I feel like it's painful, but even to watch. It's even painful to watch. Because I know Pose is a very nice guy. I know Diana, she's a very nice chick. I know Baha is a very nice guy. You understand? So when I see all these things happening, I'm just sometimes I feel why are we headed there?
Yeah, sir. Nikki Kuliza, during your days, the 2008, 2009, such things were very rare. Like at a zikwa zina happen. Na kama is why happen as ikwa ikamkwa limelight. Why do you think that sahizi zina come out na zina kuja na allegations kama hizo kubwa kubwa? Why do you think why this generation? And why not your time?
I think
is it peer pressure or
No. I think the generation that we're living in right now, and I want every young artist to hear this very keenly. Yeah? We live in a generation whereby we fight so much. So many people are fighting to become relevant, and they feed a monster. And this monster is called fame. This monster is called clout. The moment you start feeding this monster, the fame monster, this monster each and every day, the appetite grows. So if today you feed the monster with followers, tomorrow the monster will demand views. If you feed the monster with views, tomorrow the monster will demand subscribers. You understand? So each and every day, the appetite becomes bigger and bigger and bigger. And the last thing about this monster does not care about you. This monster, one day, he will eat you alive. You understand? Because the worst thing is, the more you feed it, the more it becomes bigger, and the more you feed it, the more hungry, the appetite, the hungrier it becomes. So guys need to be very careful, because this monster each and every day, because if you feel like each and every day people should be talking about you, trust you me, each and every day you'll feel like your appetite grows bigger and bigger. And the moment your appetite grows bigger and bigger, it means that is not even, you're not even in control. There's something that is in you that is controlling you. And that's the monster that is really controlling you. Be very careful of this fame thing, of this clout thing. Be very careful about it. It's good for people to talk about you, but kindly, let it be moderate, and let it be with value behind it.
To this camera, is your final advice to, you know, Willy Paul, Bahati, and Diana?
I don't think I have a title to address Ama to tell them anything to that level. All I'm just saying is, I believe they are very young, talented people who they have a great future in front of them. And I believe where they are right now, they've been walking this journey and they know how far they've gone with the music and the talent that they have. So at the end of the day, it's just for them to understand that in future, the future, the nation, the talent, and all this still needs them to do what they're doing. I just feel, if there's any reconciliation that can happen between them, I pray for reconciliation among the three of them.
Thank you so much. And congratulations about today.
Thank you.
And I'd like to find out what you're doing.
I hope you have any question.
I'll just
have a question.